Hi everyone, welcome to the 50th video of my Empire of Trebizond Art of War Let's Play, playing on Iron Man. So in a previous video, I actually managed to ally to Austria, but sadly they called me in a war against Russia and a ton of other people, so I decided to dishonor that. That could have been a mistake. Long term, Austria would be an amazing ally, and now they deeply distrust us, so getting another alliance of them is going to prove very difficult in the future. I may be able to re-ally to Russia quite soon, once I've finished annexing Crimea, which is done in about a year's time. A war against Persia is coming up in a not too distant future. We're about 4 years away from that happening. How long have we got? 67 August? And yeah, we should start to really grow again then. Can't westernize for some reason anymore, not exactly sure why. Maybe due to Portugal making us a rival in the last video. That may be the cause. I've got some rebel issues over here which I'm dealing with. Helping out Tabaristan. Hopefully they can help out over here as well, so I don't have to do it all. Right, so apart from that, I think I'm ready to get started. Right, they've gone on there. Good. Let's bring this unit over to here. So, select army. Two mercs and a cannon, that works fine for me. What's a garrison here? 864. Yeah, I probably don't want to assault, to be honest. Let's stick a cannon there. And then right, get those over there. Leave that army there. I still don't have an heir. That could cause me a heck of a lot of problems. Poland and Lithuania would currently fight over us. Yeah, that wouldn't be good, put it that way. Because I'd have to get out of that then, which would mean I wouldn't have Poland as an ally, probably. Okay, let's... and pause. That Religious Leagues war is still going on in Europe. I doubt it's going to be... well, I actually want the Protestants to win it, I think, but I don't think that's going to happen. They're losing it by 9 at the moment. I'm not sure. I think if it's inconclusive, then it's not possible for the war to happen again. The only way it can happen again is if the Protestants win this time round, then they'd be able to fight again, and the Catholics would be able to win. If it's a draw, then religion, all religions, Christian religions, are accepted within the league, I think. Something like that. There's wars going on over here against Afghanistan, so I might want to get involved in those in a bit as well. Okay. Right, so they've reached Kabul. I think all of these have been sieged now. There's no rebellion, so they have pretenders. They should win that, though. Bulk was actually finished. Let's move that to there, then. Money-wise, saving up for an embassy. We allied some Mamluks now, so the Ottomans can't attack them, which is great. We're only 2 over. Going to be 1 over shortly. And if I... well, I still want to get allied to Russia, but I could cancel them and be 0 over. Okay, which there. Got rid of my alliance to Serbia, which I may want to get back in a bit. Okay. Did help a bit in that war. Ottomans before. Okay, so this finishes in December, I think. A child in the reeds. New legal heir with a weak claim. Gain 5 ducats. That's tempting, actually. A weak claim is... he's a 513. It's terrible in diplomat points. Lose 5 prestige. National unrest for how long? Till 69. This would avoid that situation. This guy's young. It's not as if he can't have an heir anytime soon. We do get a bonus to our chance because we're Trebizond. I should arguably be making more marriages to increase the chance, which I'd forgotten about. Maybe we don't have an increased chance. I thought we did. But I can't see it anywhere here. I'm going to say no to this. I'm going to take the risk. But what I am going to do is start to make some marriages. So gain 5 ducats. And so who do I want to get married to? I don't think I can do it with Russia. We're already married to Poland. Let's ally to Astrakhan and Tabaristan. I'm not sure I can do Tabaristan actually, but I can do Astrakhan. That's gone up a bit recently. Right. That might have lowered, I'm not sure. Don't think it did actually. Let's check something. Legitimacy plus 1, yeah. I don't think it has loaded, good. Because that was changed in this patch. 1.9 patches. Right, diplomats back, I'll keep him on hand. Let's improve relations with Austria. Actually. Okay. Oops. Right, keep that diplomat on hand. Is this guy recovered yet? Nearly. Okay, cap that out. Let's come over to here. Actually, go there, go there, go there, go there, there. Patrol. Right, so that'll do it for me. Okay, diplomat is back from Austria. I'll send that to France. That's it. The Ottomans still don't have that military tech. Kabul is done. Nice. Let's group those up there. That's my force limit. 20. I'm going to get those Crimean troops soon, though. Barmais are at war. Okay, Vijayanagara didn't do very well in this game. Cocos Islands was found. Right, so I don't need to. Let's come straight down to there and I'll figure out a new route next time. Okay. Army's grouped up there. Let's bring this back over to there. Right. Ottomans are making claims again. Ottomans could actually declare war on us at the same time then when that truce runs out, as I'm able to declare war on Persia, which they might actually do, but they're still involved in that war in Europe, I think, so it's pretty unlikely, so we should be alright for them. I think, well, as long as we're that military tech ahead, we've got their number at the moment, I think, almost. Okay, so if we the cape there, let's bring this back to here. Okay. There's another colony there. Western Australia discovered. Okay, reached there. I think I'll move these back to Tabriz. Still take ages to convert. Right, cap that relations with France. Let's improve relations with Russia. Okay. Tabriz, diplomat is back. Enriched Maldives. Let's stick that on. Patrol and bring it. Actually, I think I've discovered everything over here, so... I'll wait till they repair and start discovering over here, I think. Right. Sickness of the Kin. Oh, excuse me. Right, maybe I should have taken that weak claim then. Production or trade? Trade, I probably earn more money off actually, so I'll take trade efficiency. I need an ear like yesterday now. This isn't good. Right, diplomat has arrived from Russia. A weak claim would have given me a ton of problems because I've lowered my autonomy in so many provinces. So, yeah, that would have been a massive issue. Because all of these, there's a huge amount of provinces I've lowered autonomy on here. My theologian's getting to the point where he might die as well. Right, so diplomats are back. Let's annex Crimea. Okay, Crimea integrated. Right, diplomatic reputation's reduced for 10 years again. That now means we have probable casus bellies. Well, we have Holy War casus belli on Lithuania if ever I need it, but they're allied to Poland, so probably won't be going after them anytime soon. Now, I should have acquired the navy, perhaps, if they have one, Crimea. Three. Right, I do want the galleys. I might keep the flute, though. Okay, scrap them. Bring the flutes. It's there. They have 10,000 troops here. All infantry. I'm going to keep them, obviously. We're force limit. Yes. Pretty much at force limit now. My alliance is arguably weaker though because we don't have as big a mass overall force limit anymore. Right, so Russia should have just lost that mission, and that's just changed before my eyes. Can we ally? Yes, we can. Offer alliance, send. And accepted. Right, so we're re-allied to Russia now. That worked out brilliantly. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if they get themselves another mission on us somehow, but we're going to be able to keep that for a while at least. They may get us involved in that war, but I don't think they're actually in charge of the league. Sweden is, so they shouldn't. I think I would honor it if they did, maybe. But yeah, I don't think it can happen. Right, so that's brilliant. We've come through that really iffy period by the looks of things. Now, how about reducing autonomy in Crimea? I probably need to religiously convert before I think about doing that, actually. So, ooh, that's going to be hard to do. Let's do Azaba. And Tin. Now, I could get quite a bit of rebellion issues over here, potentially. But we'll figure it out in a bit. Right, so... this war against Persia is coming up now. Let's got to prepare. I've got to prepare for that. Okay, right. Diplomats back. There's no chance of allying to France, is there? Nope. What? How strong are the Ottomans? They are actually recovering. If I were to declare war, none of my allies would join, sadly. Truce might be a reason, but maybe not. I think we're safe from the Ottomans for quite a while now. If they were to attack me when I've got Russia, Poland, and the Mamluks as an ally, they'd be in a lot of trouble. So I can do pretty much what I want over here for the time being. And then be in a good shape to attack them maybe later on or defend against them later on. Right, so I've no idea what I'm doing with my diplomats. Should I be making claims? Possibly. I could make claims against the Ottomans. I could make claims against the Omanis. But it's covert. Fabricate claim. Yeah, good chance of getting caught, so I don't think I will anytime soon. How's Afghanistan doing in their war? Go after them eventually. Let's improve relations with Astrakhan. Or Lithuania, let's do them. Astrakhan, I want to take a huge amount of territories with, so I'm not going to be diplomatizing them anytime soon. The Tabaristanis, I probably want to take all the Afghan territory and maybe the Baluchi before I diplomatize them. I might improve relations with them though. I'll keep one on hand for the time being. Okay. Put the timer up. Let's bring. Right, army's locked, so I can't do anything with it. Is that. I have to wait a month for that. I should only be one over my alliance amount now as well. Yeah. Is there any way I can reduce that? I could get rid of my alliance with Delhi, but I think it's worthwhile keeping. They would help me out against Persia in a minute. Wouldn't be a bad idea to have a good ally in India anyway. Let's bring that to there. Okay. And suppose. Money's coming up. How are we doing? Not making hardly anything at all, actually. It's because all of the autonomy over here is crap. Right. Found some archipelago. Right. Kedah. Been attacked by them, should be fine. Child in the reeds again. I think I might take it this time. 3-2-3, weak claim. The thing is, we had the event for a sickly kin. So I assume that creates more chance that my monarch will die. So, oh, actually the succession event's gone away. So what happens on his death now? Noble from the von Wettin succeeds to the throne. I think I'm going to turn this down again because I really don't want a weak claim. If I'm not going to get a succession war, then it's fine. It could come back, definitely though, so this is maybe a bad idea, but I'm going to do that again then. Okay. I want that. That can go there. Okay, can I increase my money any how? Probably not. My money's dreadful. It's because I don't have that fleet privateer in the Ottomans anymore, probably. It's going to take me so long to get to 1,000 and get that embassy, but I kind of need to because it gives me so many good bonuses, an extra diplomat and a relationship slot. I can go to there. Right, which Java? I can loot Persia and get money off them in a bit. Arguably. Let's come to there. Okay, found what's going on here. Mamluks broke their alliance in Yemen. More exploits. Let's come to there. All these islands are now connected by straits, which they didn't always used to be. Average Java Sea. Let's come to there. Okay. I found a coast there. Let's come to there. Okay, found that sea. Right, cog or flute came from Europe to there. What missions have I got? I definitely need to figure out where this is by the next video, because it probably would actually give us prestige, so maybe not. Have they changed that in this patch then? So it used to give you extra settler growth. It might have done. Let's bring that back to here, I think. Right. Wouldn't mind colonizing the Andamans. That's tropical, though. Yeah, all of these are tropical. One of... Right, that's temperate, so I want to colonize that. That's arid. I think there might be a province there, which I haven't discovered yet, so actually I need to go back there. I'll just truce run out. 67. I like to Morocco. They can appear. Actually, let's start patrol. Put it to there. Okay, they should repair first before they come out. Okay, Oman made his arrival. Probably not going to be doing too much now until near to before this Persian War. I don't think I should declare war on Afghanistan yet, or should I? Malwa would still join in. Don't really want to be at war with Malwa, maybe. Yeah, let's concentrate on Persia. I'm going to need all of my admin points, because I'm probably going to core up a lot of these territories rather than give them to Tabaristan and make them stronger. Give some of them to them. Okay. New exploits. Okay, not sure I want it on that route. Maybe I do. I'll leave it. Okay. Right, I found Minan. Okay, I'll play on for a bit more. I'll probably play on until just before that war with Persia. Right, so we found that province. Now that's arid as well. Liturgical reform. Gain legitimacy. I don't need legitimacy, so I might as well take that. I could hold off on this in case my monarch dies. I think you automatically get the top one anyway. So yeah, I won't select that. I'll just leave that here. Right. So I can also see how long it takes before this event fires. I think it's 4 months. I still don't know about this because I haven't tested it out. So this should be 4 months time. 4 or 6, I think it is. Okay, we just lost a theologian. Hopefully I've got a replacement or I'm going to start to have rebellion issues. We have an inquisitor. Right, let's hire him. How old is he? 40. So I can get these done a lot quicker. We're definitely going to have rebellion issues now, though. Because my autonomy will start to kick in a bit. Shouldn't be too bad, hopefully. Right, this timer up. Okay, more exploits. We finally got an heir. Everybody's dreadful as usual. To be honest, we started off with half decent monarchs. They were above average. I don't think we've had one that's amazingly good, but now we're getting these dreadful monarchs, which is really slowing down my progress. It's going to. Kind of need a military guy, but I can't afford it. So I'm gonna have to hold off on that. If I diplomatic Sabaristan, I would get a crazy amount of money from trade, because this trade node is actually really amazing. That's something I might want to do earlier than I was thinking of doing then. I could even move my capital, but the reason why I haven't is because it costs me admin points or diplomatic points. I need them for other things. The reason to move my capital would be for money at this stage. I would probably just want to move my trade capital to the Persian node at the moment, if I was going to move anything. But yeah, it's going to cost me too much. So, 67 August. So I'll start to prepare for war at the start of this year coming up. How are relations of Russia and Poland? Very good, actually. Right, so that initiated. What was that? March, April, May, June. So that's 4 months that took. So now we have Petrarch Authority. It ticks the top one automatic. I think I need to do Crimea and Tabriz with my missionaries when they get back. Take advantage of that extra missionary strength. So autonomy increased. Expired in Shivan. Okay, so I actually increased autonomy, did I? I don't think I'm going to decrease autonomy without a theologian then. I might have a look in between videos if I can change any of these rounds. Right. Okay, what happened there then? Bukhara will be forced to give Afghanistan 10% of their income. Bukhara will cede Badakhshan. To Afghanistan. Bukhara. It's that one they got back. Right, it's probably a good thing I didn't declare war on Afghanistan then, since they've gained new territories. Kokand is now a new sovereign state. So that's great, actually. The ally of the Ottomans has been weakened, in effect. So who are these at war with now? Looks like they're winning both of those. Yeah, that's good. Brilliant. Okay. Right. Let's run the clock. Okay. New exports, Chaya. Let's bring back to there. Right, we're gonna be at war with Persia in a minute, so maybe I need to get my fleet back in. Arguably, although they probably don't know about that yet. I could explore around Australia, because there's a ton of temperate land there. I may want to go and grab that, rather than colonize tropical first. I'm not sure yet. Keithlin is stopping Portugal from colonizing over here though, really. Or anyone else, any other European. Let's come to there. Right. Ivory in less than the Kamaland, nice. Okay, Hungary. Made Serbia rival. Musket or bow? Right, lose 15 army tradition or have my military tech cost go up until this guy dies. I think I'll have the tech cost go up, because I'm probably not going to be getting it anytime soon in the next military tech anyway. 5% isn't going to break the bank if I need to get it sooner rather than later. So yeah, I'll take that. Okay. New nation over there. Tunisia's not doing too well. We've just made some new discoveries. Okay. Let's... Right, start of next month, I'm gonna... get... Right, what's this? Right, I've made some discoveries over there. I'll bring that to there. Right, it's time to start preparing for this war against Persia then, so... I think that will have to wait until the next video, though. I've probably been around half an hour. So I'll stick my maintenance on and maybe recruit some... Well, I don't think I need any more units, actually. I've hit my top cap. My army cap. Yeah, okay, that's it for this video then. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time for the war against Persia.